So first problem, a retaining wall 8 meter high with a smooth vertical back retains a clay backfill with C is equal to 15 kilonewton per meter square, phi is equal to 15 degree and gamma is equal to 18 kilonewton per meter cube. Calculate the total active thrust on the wall assuming that tension cracks may develop to the full theoretical depth. Okay, so here there is a retaining wall of 8 meter height and it is in active condition and the backfill soil is of cohesive soil with cohesion 15 kilonewton per meter square. So active pressure at a depth of Z for the total depth Z for a C5 soil is given by Kp into Pv, that is Kp into gamma into H minus 2C root Ka. Since it is in active condition, Ka into gamma into H minus 2C root Ka. And K is 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi, so it is calculated at 0.588 and phi is equal to 15 degree. Okay, so first you draw this figure, rough sketch, and has to calculate this value and bottom value. So at the top, what will be the total pressure? Total pressure will be equal at depth Z is equal to 0. This vertical stress is 0. And there will be this component, that is 2C Ka, and is in negative value since it is tension zone, that is minus 2C root Ka, minus 2 into C15 root of Ka, that is minus 23. So here it is 23, this is minus. And at bottom, what is the value? Bottom it will be equal to Ka into gamma into H minus 2C root Ka, that is Ka, it is calculated as 0.588, gamma 18 and H height 8 meter minus 2C root Ka, we have calculated 23. So at bottom it will be 61.67. okay, next we have to calculate the critical depth or depth of tensions on ZC, because here question is to calculate the total active thrust. So in this case we have to reduce, I have told that we have to reduce this portion and has to calculate the area of this portion only. So we have to find out this depth. Okay, so the depth of tensile crack is equal to 2C gamma root Ka, we have studied. So 2 into C15 divided by gamma 18 root Ka, that is 2.172. So 2.17 is the depth of tensile crack, this depth ZC. So this depth will be 8 minus 2.17, that is 5.83. Okay, and the lateral earth pressure is negative or tensile up to a depth of 2.17, and the soil tends to break away from the wall and tension cracks develop in the soil. So the resultant active thrust is obtained by determining the area of this portion, hatched portion, this portion. Okay, so what will be the area of this portion by taking the area of this triangle, that is half into this height into this height, half into 61.67 into 5.83 is the total active thrust. Okay, so this is the final answer. So it is very simple, so you should thorough about this figure and this ZC value, equation of this ZC, 2C by gamma root Ka, and here it will be minus 2C root Ka, and here it will be Ka into gamma H minus 2C root Ka. Okay, so first calculate this height and calculate this height and take the area of this portion, so that will be Pa. Okay, next problem, an excavation was made in saturated soft clay, phi is equal to 0, that is here angle of shear resistance is 0. Okay, with its sides more or less vertical. When the depth of excavation reached 6 meter, the sides caved in. What was the approximate value of cohesion of the clay soil? Take unit weight as 20 kilonewton per meter cube. So here it is cohesive soil, but phi is equal to 0. And said that made in a saturated soft clay with its sides more or less vertical, that is there is no retaining wall for this soil, but when the depth of excavation reached 6 meter, the sides caved in, that is after the depth 6 meter it starts failing, that is up to depth 6 meter the soil could stand by itself. So what is this value? 6 meter, 6 meter is the critical height. So we have studied in the previous slide that For the height of critical depth, the soil can stand by itself. So that depth is known as critical depth, and HC, it is marked as HC. And the value of critical depth HC is equal to 2 times HC. So that is 4C into gamma root Ka. Okay. So here they have told that with that is a saturated soft clay with its sides more or less vertical. So initially it stands by itself, and when the depth of excavation reached 6 meter, it fails. That is, up to this height 6 meter, it could stand by itself. So this height is critical height. That is 4C by gamma root Ka is equal to critical height 6. So we have to calculate C. C has to be calculated. So equate 4C by gamma root Ka is equal to 6 meter, and by solving we can calculate C. That is the procedure. Okay. So here what is Ka? Ka is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. Here phi is equal to 0. So Ka is equal to 1. Okay. So 4C by gamma root Ka is 1. So 4C by gamma is equal to 6 meter. Okay. Or C is equal to 6 into 20 gamma divided by 4. 30 kilonewton per meter square. Here since this problem is from our Gopalranjan and Rao textbook, it is one mistake. Here it has to be written as 20. 4C by gamma is 20, not 4. This is one small mistake. Okay, so you skip this step. Okay, so this is the answer. C is equal to 30 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so this is the equation of critical height. That is, critical height means up to this height, critical height or critical depth, the soil can stand by itself without any lateral support. So that is the main point. So for this height 6 meter, the soil could stand by itself since it is the critical height. Okay. So up to this, I am winding Rankine's theory. So you should do more problems from your textbook, and if you have any doubt when solving one problem, please call me or WhatsApp. Okay. So next topic is Coulomb's theory of earth pressure. So I have told that for explaining lateral earth pressure, there are two theories, Rankine's theory and Coulomb's theory. And Rankine's theory we have explained for coercive soil, cautionless soil, active, passive and at rest condition. Next is Coulomb's theory. So this Coulomb's theory is not much important as far as your syllabus is concerned, and also as far as your previous question papers are referred. So I am not taking Coulomb's theory now. Okay. If anybody wants, I will take later if there is any time. Because my movement of my portion is very slow. We are only in second module. So I am not taking this unimportant portion. So these are the assumptions of Coulomb's theory. So in for 5 marks, usually assumptions will be asked. So you just by heart these assumptions. So I think you should not study the theories, Coulomb's theory. This is not much important. Okay. So you need not waste your time. But if anybody interested, please contact. Okay. So by this, our second module is over. So from next class, I will start third module. And I will try to solve more problems and upload its video. Okay. Thank you.